Everybody, it's Patty, Rockstar Mom. Thanks for watching today. Well, many of you have seen the video I did last week of Suzanne Somers' three-way poncho. And lo and behold, Leslie Hamill, who is Suzanne's daughter-in-law and the creator of the three-way poncho, saw my video, tweeted about it, and then this was the day before Thanksgiving, and then on Friday after Thanksgiving, Suzanne went out to all of her social media accounts and asked people to view my video. So Leslie and I have been, tweeting back and forth, and we have issued a little challenge to each other, sort of just to see who can come up with more ways of wearing it. So here are my different ways of wearing it. There are the original three ways that Leslie and Suzanne came up with, and then there are 17, count them, 17 different new ways that I've come up with. Some are funny, some are cute, some are practical, some are doable. If you want to see all of them, stay tuned. They're coming. Alrighty, alrighty, alrighty. Here is the first one. I have two ponchos on. I have the black one and I have the tan one. I have the tan one pulled down under my armpit and tucked that sleeve in and put the other one on just the opposite. And you can see that the sleeve there where I tucked it in makes a perfect pocket. Of course, I wouldn't want to put anything in it. Here's the second way, and I've just had it on. I pulled it up and let it drape down the back. What I would do if I wore it this way is I would turn the shirt around backwards so that I would have a deeper dip in the back. I took the black top, I stepped into it from the neck and tucked the sleeves in to the underside, pulled it up and wore the tan top on top, so it made a great skirt. This I love. I just took the cowl, pulled it over to the shoulder, pinned it with a pin, and I love this look. You could dress this up or down, but it really is cute with the pin on it. And here's a picture of it in the mirror so that you can see it. I would wear this with black leggings. Okay, this is number five. I just pinned the pin in the front and pulled it down into a V. I would have pulled it into a deeper V, actually, and smoothed it out a little bit, but that's number five. Number six, if you can see in the mirror there, I have it like a boat neck across the front with it dipping down in the back. And again, I would turn this around. I did not have it on backwards, but I would turn it around. I even draped a pair of pearls hanging in the back, long pearls, and I loved that. This next one is just a really cute idea. I just twisted that top and tied it around my head in a big bow, not really a bow, but a knot with floppy tails on the side. It was really cute. And I wrapped it like a turban and put the pin on it. Not real sure if I would wear this, but it's cute, trust me. So the next look, I took the tan top and I took a headband and put it around my neck, so a stretchy one, and it held it up there. I had to tighten it a little bit in the back and ruffled that out to make like a little drapey neck. Okay, here's another one. I simply have the tan one on. I took the black one, fold the neck down on the inside, the sleeves around the back, tied them in the back. Color blocking at its best. This is cute too. This is probably my favorite of everything I did. The tan underneath, the black on top, and I took the black and tied a tail on the side with an elastic ponytail band, and it's cute. And you can see here in a second that there we go. I am untying it. I'm going to do the same thing right in the front. That's cute too. And then there are different ways that you can actually do this. You'll see one in a minute where I pull it up on the sides, and you could easily pin that with safety pins underneath your under your arms to hold it in place. It just makes it look different. Isn't that cute? Maybe put something on the tie, a ribbon or a piece of jewelry, a pin or something there to cover the elastic, but I used an elastic in a color that, well, in black. So, and here you go, you see me pulling it up on the top. Whoops. Or pulling it up under my arms. See, I think that's cute. You could just do all kinds of things with this little. Well, it's no longer a three-way poncho. May have to change the name of this baby. All right, let's take it off. See what we can do now. Oh, listen. You're gonna like this, and I know you're gonna wear it this way. Why didn't we think of this? You know, those of you who live in the really cold climates and you forget your hat, here you go. Or you're riding in a convertible. Remember it. It'll come. This one will come in handy. All you need with this is your sunglasses. And maybe one of those cigarette holders that are about 10 inches long. Well, forget I said that last thing. Cute, huh? I like it. I can see Suzanne wearing it this way now. Okay, this is pretty neat. Leslie, I know you said you were gonna do something top side down, and this is what this is. I stepped into it. The cowl neck is the skirt part. Pulled it up, tied it around the back of my neck. I need some different underwear on there, but how cute is that? And of course, my hands were in my pockets that I made. Now I'm pulling those pockets around and tying it in the back. And there's a picture of it as the dress. Enjoy the 20-way poncho. Have a great day, you guys. I appreciate you. Don't forget to subscribe. Give me a thumbs up. Comment for sure if there's another way you can wear it. And I'll see you soon. Love you. Bye.